2019外交小尖兵英语种子队选拔活动中区初赛开始。首先为大家介绍今天现场的贵宾：外交部公众外交协调会崔静玲副执行长，外交部公众外交协调会王日升专员，教育部国民及学前教育署李芳怡小姐。感谢协办单位台中市新民高中薛光峰校长，特别感谢薛校长在防疫期间大力协助提供比赛场地以及协助比赛事宜的各位师长同学。接下来将为大家介绍今天中区初赛的五位评审。首先是逢甲大学外国语文学系郑如玉副教授，亚洲大学外国语文学系陈淑娟教授，国立彰化师范大学英语系楚湘君教授，国立台中教育大学英语学系 Martin Eventon 教授，国立勤益科技大学应用英语系苏绍文教授。现在我们就先邀请主办单位之一的外交部公众外交协调会崔静玲副执行长上台为我们致辞勉励。
各位参加今年外交小尖兵中区初赛的同学、家长、指导老师，大家好。刚刚已经自我介绍了，我就不再多说。那我先要解释一下，我们这个单位外交部的公众外交协调会，除了小尖兵以外，其实我们还有很多的活动是跟青年朋友有关的，像是如果各位在现在的高中或者是以后到大学想要到外交部来参观，都是透过我们这个单位来做联系跟安排。那将来各位如果还要再参加一些国际事务活动，我们外交部还有国际青年大使、国际农业青年大使，甚至各位将来已经毕业了，到了社会上，还有这个海外的青年度假打工，我们外交部也有一些相关的资讯跟协助，欢迎大家都来跟我们外交部做联系。那今天这个活动，首先我们当然要非常感谢提供场地的新民高中薛校长，这么多年来对小尖兵活动的协助跟支持，当然还有我们幕后的工程，做了非常多的规划跟筹办的公共电视台的制作团队。小尖兵这个活动是外交部跟教育部从1991年开始就办了，那主要的目的是透过这个竞赛活动，让同学们在校际活动当中来互相观摩学习，那也在这个活动当中能够重视英语的沟通能力，来培养团队合作的精神，那也拓展对国际事务的兴趣。19年来，已经有超过2500个学校团队，10000多名同学已经参加过这个活动。那小尖兵们在完成学业以后，有的可能会继续的出国深造，那进入职场的也有可能是担任譬如说工程师、新闻主播或者是贸易商等等。那当然有非常多的同学会来参加我们外交领事人员的特考，加入我们驻外人员的行列。那相信各位在未来的人生的旅途上，不管是在哪一个领域，都会继续的发光发热。那也期许各位在未来的人生上，继续保持对学习外国语文以及参与国际事务的一个热情跟兴趣，继续来帮我们中华民国发声，以及担任我们台湾的最佳代言人，这就是我们外交小尖兵举办的目的。那亚太地区的国家呢，在国际的地缘政治还有国际的经贸上面是扮演越来越重要的角色，所以我们今年的活动的主题就定为台湾青年行，南向博感情，也就是要希望鼓励大家对西南向政策的国家有更多的了解，那也对我们将来跟周边的国家能够有加强更多的友好的情谊。那今年我们是为了要鼓励更多的同学来参加活动，所以我们在赛制上有做了一些变动。那刚刚大家可能已经听到了，我们在初赛的时候是只有进行团体表演，那到了决赛的时候我们再来进行即席演讲跟益智问答。那初赛的时候呢，我们每一区会有 八名的优胜的学校团队呢进入决赛，因为往年是只有六队，我们今年特别增加了两队，那三区加起来24队，我们在12月10号会进入决赛，到了决赛再来进行这个即席演讲跟一致问答。那也非常感谢各位呢，因为现在武汉肺炎的关系，希望大家不会感到一些困扰，我们主要还是要遵守中央疫情指挥中心的规定啊，有一些防疫的措施，谢谢大家的配合。那至于决赛最后选出来的前三名的参访活动呢，我们会再根据那个时候的疫情的状况跟疫情指挥中心来做一个协调，看看怎么样来做一个安排，我们再来跟大家来做报告。那待会呢，我们大概就会看到各位同学精彩的演出了，你们不管是有什么样的创意让你们进行的发挥，也要展现你们的团队合作的精神。那也希望以后在不同的场合，在参与国际事务的活动当中，能够跟各位再度的见面，希望各位大家一起来帮我们拼外交，谢谢。那最后也就是祝福大家平安健康，
请留步。
那我们请副执行长先行留步。今年因为疫情的关系，协办学校台中市新民高中薛国峰校长在场地以及行政规划上给予主办单位非常大的协助及帮忙，因此主办单位特别制作了感谢状，邀请薛校长上台。我们也邀请副执行长为我们致赠感谢状。现在我们邀请薛校长为我们的同学勉励，也请崔执行长先行回座。
外交部公众外交协调会署副执行长王专员，教育部国民教育署李小姐，各位同学，各位师长，大家早安，还有我们各位评审，大家早安，大家好，谢谢。一年一度外交小尖兵又再度来到新民高中来做竞技比赛，这一次有37个非常优秀的学校推荐的杰出的代表来做竞技，天气非常好，希望各位有好的表现，我们希望新民高中提供给各位的场地服务及各项服务能够让大家在整个表现上顺利圆满成功，祝大家，谢谢。
我们谢谢薛校长，薛校长为我们的勉励，也先请他回座。第7队请至第一准备区，现在请第1队上台。
That no one likes me. Since I was born, those repulsive pests are always coming, leaving me sick and spoiled. How much I wish I could look as appealing as those on the calendars.
Why do I fail again? I've made every effort and spent no time growing melons. But the problem still remains unsolved. Are there any hope left out there?
Southeastern Asia. It is reported that the policy has been implemented and the financial subsidy is provided. How about I cooperate with agricultural experts and make investment there? Not only will a past problem be solved, but it will generate considerable benefits.
What else could I do? And the problem gets more and more serious.
Who are you? Why are you here?
Excuse me, businessman from Taiwan, and he is an agricultural expert. I think we can help you deal with the problem.
Really? This sounds great. But how? It's really annoying and frustrating that the quantity of sweet melons keeps unstable because of the pests and diseases, and all the efforts are just in vain.
We have got special techniques to prevent sweet melons from being infected. And I think if we can collaborate, your sweet melons might thrive again.
Really? This sounds great. But I have either tried to spray a variety of pesticides or blanket the whole sweet melon trees. Are there really any techniques else?
Yes. Based on our latest study, sweet melons' roots are vulnerable. So first, we need to get rid of the rootlets and then put good bacteria on it to hinder the growth of microorganisms.
Also, spray some essential oil made from citrus. It can prevent sweet melons from being infected.
I see. If this technique could be applied.
Hopefully, the quantity and the quality of sweet melons can be improved in leaves and buds.
Let's start from the scratch.
My rootlets have been rid of. Good bacteria have been put on me. And essential oils have been spread over and over. What on earth is the problem?
The latest and advanced techniques have been applied. Why? Why do pests still inflict on these sweet melons?
I don't get it. Fouls, subsidies, technology, professionals from Taiwan are all devoted to improve this situation.
Wait! Is it possible that the weather in Southeastern Asia is one factor that we have ignored? Warmth and humidity both contribute to the reproduction of pests.
What do you usually do to alleviate these problems?
We usually fight against the pests with the natural enemy. But as you know, it's not effective.
Let me think. How about your method and our technique are combined together?
It sounds feasible. Let's try again.
My happiness is beyond description. Now, I'm not only as cute as those on calendar, but also on the market around the world.
If it were not because of your investment and the following marketing strategies, sweet melons from Southeastern Asia couldn't dominate the market as today.
If it were not because of your cutting-edge technique, our sweet melons could not prosper.
Most important of all, if it were not for your traditional wisdom, my techniques could not be successful.
It is every one of us, either from Taiwan or Southeastern Asia, either belongs to humans or non-humans, such as cumulus like me. Let's make our dream possible. Let's do it
over and over! Thank you!
mind pain.
We have a patient needing an immediate liver transplant. You are an expert in this field in Taiwan. I'll be more at ease with your instruction during the surgery.
I would love to help, but I can't fly to Vietnam now because of COVID-19.
Well, maybe we can conduct it through video chat.
Well, liver transplants have never been performed through video chat. Still, it's worth a try.
Awesome! We're planning to conduct the surgery 2 weeks later.
2 weeks later. Are rampant in Vietnam. Our medical team used to fly to Vietnam to help with the surgery. Today, we believe that through telehealth and exchange program of resident training, health for all is available around the world.
I have already thanked you in person.
Well, as a medical worker, that was what we should do. By the way, I didn't know you are the director when we were on the plane.
Director Lee, Dr. Ray is on the line.
Okay, put me on.
Hi, Dr. Lee. And Ping, how's everything?
Couldn't be better. I even went jogging before the con call.
Really? Sasha's liver is alive and kicking. Next time her liver is crying, Ping will be there.
Well, Dr. Lee and Dr. Ray, Taiwan's medical power has spoken for itself through this year. Not to mention your high-tech and manufacturing industry.
Yeah, in my opinion, Taiwan certainly deserves to join CPTPP and play an important role in second supply chain in the region.
Wow, thanks for your support.
You saved my life. This experience let us know Taiwan's advantage. I'm sure Taiwan is fully qualified.
Many thanks. I know you like Taiwan's cover of whiskey. Next time, it'll be my treat.
Your lover.
Don't worry, P. Just a tiny sip.
Thank you.
Shade.
This
morning, I found that my pants and flesh sheet were full of blood, and my mom told me to come here.
My mom told me to come to the concierge. I've been bleeding for 3 days. Am I going to die?
My mom sadly was normal. When she was young, she had gone through this too.
Really? Then why are we bleeding?
This is a normal physiological phenomenon that only happens to women. It's called menstruation, and it usually lasts 5 to 7 days, so you don't have to be worried. By the way, why aren't you doing anything to deal with it?
We use rags to absorb the blood if we have some. Otherwise, we'll just let the blood flow all over.
I have seen some clothes and a terry pads in India. Maybe I have some right now.
Thank you. I think it will be helpful.
How can we use them? I'll take you home and teach you how to use even how to make them.
Sure.
Hey, Bing Sa, where are you? I have something to discuss with you. Bing Sa? Lisa, where are you?
Hey.
Now you two have used a cloth sanitary pads. It's time to promote cloth sanitary pads to let more people know about them.
Wow, that's a great idea. But how?
Maybe we can get local women and work together in making cloth sanitary pads.
Right. Invite your family to come over and see these beautiful things you guys made. I will explain everything to them.
A day later.
Today, we are here to get to know ourselves better and introduce cloth sanitary pads, which can make our lives comfortable and relaxing during our menstruation.
How can you deal with the bleeding? It will bring better to people who see it.
The cloth sanitary pads can help us absorb the blood so that no one will see it.
Yes, I refilled at ease in the past 3 months. I can go everywhere I want to.
I still have some doubt about cloth sanitary pads, but maybe I would like to give it a try.
Two years later, they successfully promoted cloth sanitary pads to the world.
Welcome back to the Annie Show. I'm our anchor, Annie. In Nepal, making clothes sanitary pads is one of the main industries. Today, let us visit Nepal and check it out.
Yes, I hear you.
Excuse me, can you tell us what you're doing?
Okay, well, I'm making clothes sanitary pads, and this is our founder, Claire.
Can I interview you and ask you some questions?
Sure.
You established this workshop to help Nepalese women. Can you tell us what inspired you to do such a wonderful deed?
These days, cloth sanitary pads are more and more popular in the world. But when I got here, they hadn't been common yet.
Yes, because of Claire, we started to have a new life and are able to enjoy a wonderful world. And now, we are even girlfriends.
Claire is changing lots of women's lives, improving hygiene standards, enhancing and glorifying the rights of females.
Yes, we appreciate her contributions and how we can be friends forever.
Wow.
Thank you for your watching.
La 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 la. Ah! Vivian, this is a badminton training school, not an opera.
Amber, I received a suspicious letter from someone.
Fishy. Are you in any trouble?
No. Not that I know of. Anyway, here it says, Dear Vivian and Amber, from the past competitions, we have noticed that you are two strong young players. You are cordially invited to Victor's badminton camp in Malaysia.
Exactly. Let me tell you about the organizer, Victor, a famous Taiwanese sports brand. It hopes to bring Taiwanese and Malaysian young players together with a sponsorship.
Okay, stop. I got this. But who are you? And how did you get in here?
Part of my
my intrusion. But I was granted permission from your principal to speak with you. My name is Tiffany. I will be the host for the camp.
And
all the participants will get durians straight from Malaysia.
We are young, not naive.
You're right. That's not the point. The camp is in need of players like you to raise funds for the underprivileged young players in Malaysia.
Durians? Malaysia, here we come.
What?
Happy birthday to me, Durians.
Hey, Viv, today's your birthday, isn't it? Look, I've got a present for you.
Oh, D-Phone 11? It's my favorite light purple. How can I thank you? I know. I will give you this special durian.
Oh boy, look, someone's crying. With all due respect, I'm glad she forgot about the durian.
I don't mean to cry, but what's wrong?
I, Kumbo, a badminton player, almost got recruited for the Malaysian national team. But a wealthy opponent with bountiful resources beat me in the final. Now, I'm so lost.
Don't worry, I know just the right place for you. How about joining us at Victor's Badminton Camp? All registration fees and badminton facilities will be donated to help out those in need.
Cool, I'm signing up. This is my chance. Yes!
Welcome to Victor's Badminton Camp. As you all can see, this is a perfect place for badminton players to develop friendship. Now, let's play ball.
Genius!
Yeah, you're awesome!
So are you. I came from a destitute family. Look, I've been using this racket for 10 years. Being part of this event will not only help those youngsters in need, but also myself.
Even though we just met, we would like to be your friends
and stand by you.
Thank you. No one has said something so encouraging to me since my mother passed on. I promised her I would make her proud one day.
What does not kill you will make you stronger. I have faith that we will make it happen together.
Opening ceremony of the Kumbo Foundation. I'm honored to introduce to you my longtime friends, Amber, Vivian, and particularly the founder, Kumbo.
Years ago, when Kumbo was mired in her loss,
without hesitation, we did a fundraiser to help out.
Yes, here I am, able to establish this foundation for teenage players facing hard times, all because of my Taiwanese friends' unwavering dedication and patronage. So, my partners, thank you.
Friendship's outbound, events abound, let's pay forward! Thank you.
Let's
tastes really fantastic. I'll remember this flavor in my heart forever.
Years later.
Hey mom, what are you doing?
I'm just looking through some old photos. Do you still remember Auntie Anisha?
Yeah, of course. You've never stopped telling me your stories with her in Taiwan.
I would really like to visit her, but you know, we just can't afford to go.
Oh, speaking of this, remember the application for the new Southbound Talent Development Program?
Yes.
I've earned an opportunity to be part of the internship program. And yes, I'm going to Indonesia.
That's so fantastic. It would be great if you visit Auntie Anisha for me.
I will.
Chase my dream to be a singer just like my mother.
Wow.
But I still want to get an education.
Oh, don't worry about that. Actually, I'm here because of the educational program that's part of the new cell phone policy. And I'm pretty sure that our governments also provide a program for a student like you to come.
Oh, so you mean it's like an exchange program?
Yes. It includes engineering, management, technology, and many other options. Oh, and they even provide scholarships.
Oh, wow, that's definitely what I'm searching for.
Just give it a shot. You can fill out information on your website, and I'll help you with the plan.
Okay, great. I'll get started right away.
Okay.
Ow.
Have some plum sugar cake, honey.
Thanks.
Let me show you around.
Eddie not only studied hard, but also diligently pursued his singing career.
Oh, hey, you busy?
A little bit, but what's up?
I'm listening to this song, 告白气球, and I don't quite understand the lyrics.
Okay, which line?
我手一杯，品尝你的美.
Oh, that means stop pushing! Oh, sorry for that. That means a cup of coffee in my hand tastes your beauty.
Oh, the producer sure knows his lyrics.
Best in Taiwan. Hey, this is my stuff.
Okay.
Gotta go. Bye.
Bye. Yo,
hey.
It's been a long time since our last chat.
Seriously? We just made a call yesterday. Guess what I'm eating?
Oh, come on, how would I know?
Plum sugar cake.
I'm eating 满汉大餐, and that's way better than yours.
I don't want to start a fight.
Oh, hey, how's the internship? Everything's fine here.
Hmm.
My grades on engineering had a significant improvement.
Wow, nice to hear that.
Well, actually, I'm calling to inform you of the upcoming performance of mine, which I've been preparing for quite a while, and I really hope you'll come. It would mean a lot to me.
Of course. So when is it?
Oh, it's in 2 months.
What? Oh, definitely didn't pack everything up already.
Okay then, see you there, bye.
talking if you're spitting blood. You look like you cough your lungs out.
That is not blood. That is betel nut.
What? Betel nut? What's that?
You never heard of betel nut? Where are you from?
Australia. Us Aussies don't have that in our country.
Australia, I see. All right, let me introduce you then. Betel nut first originated in India, then widespread to Southeast countries such as the Philippines, Malaysia, Sri Lanka, then reached Taiwan a few thousand years ago.
What was that used for back then?
Well, betel nut is used especially by the Aboriginals, for example, the Amis. For them, betel nut symbolizes love.
Love? Oh.
Yeah, and during their harvest festival, the girl would put her betel nut in her alufu.
Alufu?
Yes, and when she sees the boy she likes, she would take the betel nut and give it to the boy.
Oh.
What's more, if the boy eats it right away, it means that he likes her back as well.
Oh, how special a betel nut can mean to different tribes of people.
Japanese colonization from 1895 to 1945. The Japanese banned betel nut due to the negative impact it brings to the society. Taiwan's revolution, the planting and consumption of betel nut has boomed again, and this time at an incredible speed, with a production value over 13 billion and the cultivated lands of betel nut reaching almost 60,000 hectares in 1997.
Hey, you want to try mine?
Sure. Wow, my body feels so warm, and I can even feel a spice of it. You should try mine too.
Oh, why so sour?
Oh, because there's plum powder in it.
Breaking news, Liz Jessing. A landslide from Nantou County. Again, another environmental disaster caused by the vast amount plantings of betel nut trees.
Impact betel nut can bring. It actually also holds a positive side. The betel nut stem can actually be used as a raw material when it comes to activated carbons.
Really? I've only heard that activated carbons can be used for the other end, like cells or something.
Well, in this case, betel nut can be turned into decomposable plastic. So we can actually replace our daily plastic with these decomposable ones, and we can try our best to halt the exacerbation of global warming.
I think that's a brilliant idea. I can't wait to bring this thing to my people.
An image.
That's awesome. Where is it?
It is in Vietnam, which is famous for party street food and stunning landscape.
It sounds like you really have some wealth.
Duh! I really want to soak up your local culture and nature environment. I just hope that I have the opportunity to visit Vietnam once. Just once!
Stop being so dramatic! Don't you know that the prevalence rate of liver disease is quite high in Vietnam? If I'm not getting it wrong, Vietnam has been estimated that there are 7.8 million chronic hepatitis B patients and 1 million chronic hepatitis C patients.
Nah, there's nothing that could destroy my sweet fantasy about Vietnam. Just don't be so serious.
Sorry, occupational hazard. Hey, since you are so desperate, just wait for the next mission time and maybe we'll be assigned to Vietnam.
Professor Falcon, no way, it's my turn.
Look, what's that? Hey, you cheated!
Hello?
Girls, it's me, Professor. There is an emergency call. A mother and her child from Vietnam need your help. Now, transfer to Vietnam immediately so you can clarify the situation.
Roger! It's mission time! Hurry, let's go get him!
I won't believe there will be any solution.
Mom, your concept is way too traditional. Listen, I just heard from two Taiwanese that Taiwan is trying to assist Vietnam in the prevention and treatment of liver disease.
But how?
Taiwan government proposed a new southbound policy, medical and health cooperation and industrial chain development. It carries out the model of one country, one center.
Keep going, I'm listening.
That is to say, every country listed as a key target will have a hospital that's responsible for coordinating our units through talent training, resource searching, and industrial linkage. Things are looking up in Vietnam. Anyway, cut the crap. Actions speak louder than words.
Huh? What do you mean?
That means we're going to a hospital. Someone has already handled all the medical procedures for you. Come on.
What?
Nervous about.
Yeah, doctors here are well trained by Taiwan's medical team.
Moreover, we also treat Vietnamese patients of liver disease through remote consultation.
Whew, that's a lot off my mind.
Here, follow me and let's get your diagnosis started.
Oh, thank you so much. It is so hard to find words to express my gratitude.
It is my pleasure. We will always be here for you. Go ahead, your mom needs your company.
And mission.
Wait for me!
Mission complete!
The cooperation between Taiwan and Vietnam enables us to show the spirit of medical without borders.
It is not only the pursuit of commercial interests, but the amount of investment.
It is through good medical interaction that establishes a differentiate between these two countries.
Together,
we can make a difference!
DJ, drop the beat!
We are Taiwanese Vietnamese fighting for disease. By sharing and loving, we can all succeed.
Yeah, leave no one behind. One
country, one center.
Bow.
Thank you.
Hello?
Hi, brother. It's nice to hear your voice. How's the typhoon there?
As usual. Busy pumping water here.
Again? I told you not to cut down the mangroves. They are the shield against typhoons.
Jenny, without cutting down the mangroves, how should I set up shrimp farms and pay your tuition fee?
Talking about school, I have a big test tomorrow. Talk to you later.
What test?
Don't worry about that. How can I save the mangroves?
Aren't we experts?
Of course. We've studied marine science for almost 4 years.
You guys are right. Let's go to Indonesia!
Wait, what?
This silly girl and her mangroves.
Cut down as many mangroves as you can! You can cover all your sister's needs!
Jin, you do not only care about money, right?
What's so important about mangroves? You are just trying to give her a better life!
No! You will damage the entire environment!
That's okay. No one will blame you.
Mangroves? Shrimps? Mangroves? Shrimps? What should I do?
Hi, Jim!
Jenny, what are you doing here? Don't you have school?
It's fine. It will pass for an internship. I also brought my friends here.
Yeah, I have heard about your science, but microallergies won't do any good.
It's microalgae.
Actually, they can help. Don't you get tired of building a shrimp farm every other year?
That's just the way it is. Cause mangroves from shrimps make money.
You're doing harm to the mangroves, show land.
I'm nothing about shrimp farming.
Destroy the environment. Keep going.
Don't tell me how to
Shin,
do
it. Right?
Yes, you must be Dong and Shenny.
It's Danny and Sean. We've started this exact problem you have. Can we borrow a piece of land for a little experiment? You have nothing to lose.
All right, suit yourself.
Thanks.
Why are my shrimps all dead? I worked so
hard! Wow! Check it out! Look at that!
Jim!
It's amazing!
And those
big tiger shrimp! With no breeding density, we can farm the king of shrimps!
Each one grows 4 times bigger than before!
Whoa! They are energetic!
Yeah, they must be healthy!
Science does come in handy! This microalgae in Dotai 20 is rich in proteins and minerals, which means
antibiotics can be replaced! We can increase shrimp's immune system organically.
So,
would you like to try it?
Yes, but what if I fail? I won't be able to support Jenny.
What if you succeed? Jenny can take care of herself now. There's no need to worry about her.
She will soon find a job.
Right, she's not a little girl anymore. Then, how about my shrimp business?
That's why we are here. Let us show you!
The most important feature is shrimps will live with mangroves.
More and more people are willing to purchase this kind of organic product.
It can enhance economic efficiency.
What's all the noise?
We will give you two some space. Don't fight.
Jenny, help me with the nets.
What do you think about the result?
It's a great success.
So?
I want to make some changes.
Really? I'm glad to hear that. And I'm sorry, I shouldn't yell at you.
What under the bridge, sister?
I owe you so much.
Today, I owe you and your friends.
Where's Danny and Sean?
Danny, have this barbecue shrimp. Smells good. But I still miss Big Tiger Shrimp.
Me too. That was an amazing summer in Indonesia.
Hi, Jenny.
Jim.
Hi, Sean. Danny.
Happy Moon Festival. Did you get the moon cakes we sent you?
Yes, I love them. They're delicious.
We also sent a box of Big Tiger Shrimp to Taiwan. Did you get it?
No, not yet.
Surprise!
Shrimp Jenny!
You're in Taiwan!
It's a moon festival for friends and family's reunion.
You still remember? How's the mangroves and shrimps?
They are doing well. Thanks to your Indotai 20.
It's not our Indotai 20. It's Jenny and we all. After all, Indotai 20 means the cooperation between Indonesia and Taiwan.
Without new southbound policy, I wouldn't have a chance to study in Taiwan and meet you guys.
So our friendship
and shrimp,
friendship forever! Thank you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ron. I'm afraid that we have a bad news to inform you. Your daughter has been diagnosed as PFIC, which is very rare. And due to a medical technology in Finland, the success rate of 11 months old liver transplantation patients is very low.
Doctor, please help us. I've run so many hospitals already, but there's still no one can save my child.
I'm so sorry, but we already did our best to save your daughter.
Oh, Taiwan's medical technology is famous all over the world. I think we can ask Taiwan for help. I have a cousin who works in Taipei Veterans General Hospital, and we can contact Red Cross through him.
Taiwanese doctor promised to go to Vietnam to assist. Two days later, Taiwanese doctor finally came to Vietnam for medical assistance.
This is the most difficult operation in Vietnam, and also an impossible task with the Vietnamese medical technology. Moreover, it sets a new record for the youngest liver transplant in Vietnam.
Let's make America together.
After 10 hours, the doctor walked out of the operation room.
Thank you.
Don't mention it. This is not a real test for Taiwan's medical technology. I'm glad we have help for your country.
Doctor, how about my daughter now?
Congratulations, the operation was successful.
Thank you so much.
We will transfer to your daughter to the observation for a week later. Well, your wife will transfer to General Road to the recuperation.
Okay, thank you so much. Welcome to watch the press conference of Taiwan and Vietnam's medical exchange in Vietnam.
Doctor, could you tell us some actors about this operation?
Humanitarian aid is every country's duty. Moreover, doctor's life of save precious life for sure. Thank you. Any questions?
This is TVBC from Taiwan, and I have a question for Vietnamese doctor. What do the Vietnamese hospital think about my country's medical assistance this time?
We are very clear that Taiwan is Taiwan and China is China, so we especially use traditional Chinese characters, but not simplified Chinese characters during the meeting. We hope to respect Taiwan by using your own language. Thank you. Any questions?
This is KTV from Taiwan. I want to ask, quite interaction between the two countries. Do you expect?
Although Taiwan and Vietnam don't have formal diplomatic relations in status quo, however, the economic and trade exchange was very close. We hope to do more exchange of medical technology in the world to the future.
Any further questions? Since there is no more questions, then this is the end of press conference. Thanks for all the reporters' hard work. Bye.
Thank you.
Travel restrictions have finally been lifted. At last, I can visit my mom's homeland, Vietnam.
Gosh, the motorcycles, the air quality is so bad.
Let's get out of here, quickly.
Phew, that's better.
Is this your cousin's house?
Yes.
Overnight?
Rich? Have you forgotten all of our childhood memories? We always went fishing under Dongzhuai.
Who still uses those bamboo boats today? Motorboats are everywhere now, just like motorbikes outside.
We also use bamboo to make all these handicrafts.
You can't keep trying to earn a living by doing crafts like this. You have to change.
This is so intricate. My great-grandfather made it for me.
Your great-grandpa? Wow, it's in really good shape for something so old.
That's because bamboo is strong. This has always inspired me to be tough and persistent in the face of difficulties.
Maybe this can help.
What are you talking about?
How about building a bamboo bike? You said yourself that bamboo is strong, so we can use it to make sharper friends. Bamboo can also be used as a fuel source. Burning bamboo charcoal generates far less carbon emissions than all your best fuels.
Wow! So it would act like a bamboo battery?
Exactly. And we Taiwanese could provide the technology to make your bamboo bikes viable.
Sounds amazing. It could work.
It will definitely not work. Why not? Who are you?
Mr. Khan, the motorcycle industrialist. Listen, the Vietnamese people won't just replace their motorcycles with these overnight. You don't even have a concept design yet.
Hey, we can figure this out.
Yes? What? Is she all right? Oh, thank you.
What's the matter?
My daughter has a severe asthma attack. She's in the hospital. Has it ever occurred to you that all the air pollution around here is aggravating her asthma? I have never thought of that before. Wait, if those bamboo field bikes can really be made,
then this bamboo forest can be a solution.
I'll tell you what. You designed a viable bamboo field motorbike.
And you're not going to cut down my bamboo forest.
That's right. I'll build a factory to produce these bikes. We can cooperate.
Yeah! Hey guys, let me tell you. Every part of the bamboo plant, including the stems, rhizomes, leaves can produce biofuels.
This way, we can use a renewable energy source to power our bikes.
Hey, it's done! Let's manufacture them!
Hooray!
Hi, Chick!
Bonzoi! How have you been?
Great! Our bamboo bike project is working.
factories ESG rating has risen to 3A.
ESG?
I've heard of it from the news. Let's see, it's environmental, social, and...
corporate governance, that's it. But how did you get a 3A rating?
Since Vietnam's population replaced their air-polluting motorcycles with our eco-friendly bikes, we created more sustainable living spaces.
Which has shown that we take our environmental responsibilities seriously.
Our brainchild has improved the air quality and fostered a deep friendship among Vietnam and Taiwan.
Hey, I got to go. My daughter and wife are waiting for me to ride home together.
Ride safe and ride clean.
Thank you. Oh my banjoy.
G, green environmental concepts.
I, innovations in technology.
F, friendship among the youth.
T, traditional bamboo art.
This is a gift that can make a difference for our southern neighbors. Thank you.
You don't even know the first name of my country.
You're in Taiwan, not in Malaysia. We're in Taiwan, drink as Taiwanese drink.
Chill, bro. It's just a drink.
It's not just a drink. It's an cultural icon. You're challenging our culture.
This is Milo, Taiwan style. Take it or leave it.
We meant you no harm. Just thought you came from Malaysia. So we bought a cup of Milo to make you feel at home.
I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it.
What's wrong with you? The school fair is coming 3 weeks away. Our theme is exotic flavor this year. How can you talk to him after that?
Enough is enough. I'm out here.
Robin!
Hey, Sebastian. How's life treating you in Malaysia?
Can't complain. And you?
Oh, the Asian student from Malaysia, STEM. He freaks me out. Why are they so obsessed with Milo?
Let me tell you what I have experienced in Malaysia, which will make you guys appreciate STEM's feelings. After sampling lots of food in Malaysia, I found out the flavor here is quite sweet and strong. By the way, do you have a Milo with you?
You mean right now?
Yep.
I don't get it, but
here you go. Take a look at where it was produced.
Oh! No wonder Stan reacted like that.
It's their national pride.
Oh, this is terrible.
What did you do?
I insulted him and yelled at him.
You have to apologize to him. Each place has its own culture. We should understand it and respect it.
Okay.
Hey, there's an exhibition about Malaysian culture. The Adventures into Southeast Expo. Go check it out.
Sure thing. Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Welcome to the Adventures into Southeast Expo. This is the Malaysian Pavilion. I'm your tour guide, Paul. I'm gonna introduce to you the Malaysian culture, cuisine, clothing, and specialties, including nasi lemak or coconut milk rice. Baju Malay, a traditional Malay outfit for men. Durians, and the national drink of Malaysia, Milo.
Excuse me. What is the difference between the Milo in Taiwan and in Malaysia?
Fair question. The Milo in Malaysia tastes sweeter and richer, more smooth in texture. Here, give it a try.
Wow, this is heaven!
No wonder Stan isn't a fan of the Milo in Taiwan. Can I have another one? Sure, here you go.
I guess I shouldn't have been so mean to Stan the other day.
See, I told you. I think you owe him an apology.
I had to admit, but you're right.
Stan, we're now at the Adventures into Southeast Expo. Robin wanna be in peace, ASAP.
I happen to be interested in this expo too. I'll be there.
big of a devil.
Hi, didn't expect to see you here.
I got a little homesick.
Okay. I have to apologize for my attitude and the lack of respect to your culture.
It's okay. The drink you gave me was just a friendly gesture. I don't know what got it to me. Friends?
Friends!
I don't know if this is the best time, but the school fair is almost upon us. Oh, now I remembered. The thing is exotic flavor, right?
Exactly.
I think I got just the thing for you.
Let me guess. Milo!
Bingo! Yes!
I got a great idea. What about combining pearl milk tea with Milo? A combination of specialties between Taiwan and Malaysia.
Whoa! This baby is gonna fly off the shelves!
And it is the symbol of the friendship between us and between the two countries.
Our friendship was on the rocks!
Not anymore. Let's huddle up!
Friendship
rocks!
Thank you! Hey guys! Have you ever seen the movie Turtle's Journey, The Crisis in Our Ocean?
Yeah, the animation shows how serious the ocean pollution is in the real world.
Human beings are producing over 300 million tons of plastic every year.
What?
Roughly 8 million tons are dumped into the ocean to join the 150 million tons already there.
Oh, that's too bad.
I remember reading a research. About 80% of ocean garbage is from Asia, mainly from the Philippines, Vietnam, Thailand, Indonesia.
As volunteer students of a southbound policy, what can we do about it?
I come up with an idea. How about a plastic bank?
Why is a plastic bank?
Oh, they turn plastic into cash. To be more specific, they work with local people. In other words, they cooperate with poor people who seek to have a stable income to offer their daily life.
Fantastic! I know about the New Southbound policy that emphasizes the significance of cultural innovation and cultural exchange. We can take this idea and help the poor in Southeast Asia.
Great! And we can deal with the plastic trash at the same time. Let's work together and start a Manila slum, the Philippines.
Let's do it!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Captain speaking. Welcome aboard Plants Airline from Taiwan to Philippines. For your safety, please fasten your seatbelt. Thank you.
Since this is an environmentally friendly airline, we won't offer any plastic products in this flight. Thank you.
National anthem. Oh, and these are what I had collected for the whole day. Could you please take a look?
No problem. I'll wait it. Check it for the quality and transfer the value into your account.
Thank you so much. I really don't know how to express my gratitude.
Don't mention it. You have done a lot to make the environment better.
Because of the project, I'm able to earn money. My daughter and my son can go to school.
It's a saving account.
and it's my property. It's online. So I'm not afraid of robbery. And I'm no longer hopeless and helpless.
It's really a win-win situation.
Hey!
Robbery doesn't pass the garbage and help those who are in need.
Sleeping?
I don't know.
Sorry, I'm late.
Okay, let's start it. We can use a platform of the sailbound policy and pass it ban in Cambodia, Burma, Indonesia, Thailand, and Vietnam, etc.
Exactly. I can write a proposal.
I will arrange long-distance meeting with thousands of volunteers in these countries.
Li Ho, I'm a volunteer from Taiwan.
Sawadika, I'm a volunteer from Thailand.
Wait. We have to discuss how to travel with the plastic garbage we have collected.
Well, the plastic we collect, we add value to it. We sort it, we remove labels and caps.
We either shred it or pack it into bags and get it ready for export.
Then, we sell the plastic to the great brands like Adidas, Nike, H&M, Coca-Cola, who are using such a plastic into their manufacturing.
Wow!
Oh my, I'm so smart. Right, honey?
Oh yeah! We have closed the loop in the circular economy.
We can now use our recyclings to support and create recyclers.
Hey guys, look what I found.
Oh, recently, there is an activity called cooperation between Taiwan and Vietnam. Taiwan is volunteers to help the Vietnamese to clean their environments.
At the same time, we also offer them opportunity to promote the economy condition. We invite all the volunteers who are willing to help to join us.
Let's go! Thank you!
So let me get this straight. You want me to fly 5 hours and 20 minutes with a random employee just to get this construction opportunity? Yeah, I know it's important, but I don't even know who to take with.
Hey, I'm new intern Joanna. You must be Mr. Smith.
Yeah, just a second. On second thought, I'll call you back. Hi there.
Let me just first say, I'm so glad to be here. To get a job right after I graduate is a dream come true. But this job is way more than a dream. I've been waiting for this opportunity forever.
Uncomfortable on airplanes?
No. I'm not.
Excellent. Pack your bags. We're going to Jakarta.
Wait, Mr. Smith. Did you just say we're going to Jakarta? For what?
We're building an MRT system. Let's go.
MRT? In Jakarta? Sir.
I'm telling you, we can't give you a definite answer. Still need more time to think.
Sir, I don't think you see the whole picture. People are upset, and the terrible traffic is stopping them from getting to places. As the largest construction corporation nationwide, I have total confidence that we are the best choice to get these problems all solved. All we need is your permission, sir. Just say yes, and we can just start working on it.
I completely understand, but since it'll be a great project, oh, here they are. You must be Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Nice to meet you. Here, take a seat.
Thank you. Joanne, hand that out. Via the new southbound policy, our company was informed of this possible business collaboration by the government. Our company has been devoted in providing the best construction sites via BIM for years. And we have total confidence in providing Jakarta another successful project.
Wow, interesting. BMI technology.
Pardon? Oh, sir, you mean BIM, Building Information Modeling. It's over there. Joanne can explain.
A BIM is a digital representation of physical and functional characteristics of a facility. While traditional building design largely relied on two-dimensional design diagrams, BIM not only shows the three-dimensional model, but also provides information about time, cost, asset management, and sustainability, further reducing the rate of error.
It sounds promising and worth a try.
Excuse me, but will the overall price be higher?
Yes, and so will the quality. And quality is always our priority, ma'am.
We, as the local corporation, are able to offer quality that better suits our people's needs than foreigners.
Oh, I'm sure that with the advanced techniques to assist us, we'll be able to overcome this tiny hurdle.
You call that tiny hurdles?
But I do think that BIM is something more feasible.
Thank you, sir.
But let me deliberately evaluate everything and inform you of my decision later. I gotta go. There's still meetings awaiting.
Well then, Joanne, let's go.
Just let me be clear. I know your technology is probably a bit better than ours, but just stop snatching away our country's opportunity.
We're terribly sorry.
I really need to get this deal.
Are you okay? Clearly not. Okay, hey, listen. I understand that we're both striving to get this deal, but actually, we don't have to do it this way.
Huh?
Maybe we can collaborate. I just came up with the idea that perhaps our company can be responsible for
the arrangements?
Yeah, and the risk assessment. I believe with your experience in the local construction, our project is going to work out more smoothly and efficiently.
Yeah, sure. That's gonna work.
I knew I saw something in you, Joanne. Well done. And you? I'm sorry, I was a bit cold earlier, but I truly do believe that cooperation is the best way. With your talents and our techniques, I hate to say this, but we need you.
Indeed. If we offer our tech to talents in Jakarta, not only will construction project greatly benefit, but also we might be able to offer Jakarta's construction a brighter future, and thus create a win-win situation. And we could be friends, maybe.
Sure. Since you just arrived in Jakarta, let me show you around and we could further discuss about our collaboration. Let's go.
Yay. Hey.
Wow, so you're trying to collaborate.
That's right.
We will also offer local experts training, and we can further foster our friendship. Visualize a future where Jakarta's heavy traffic is no longer bothering commuters.
And our collaboration will turn out as the veins running for decades, representing our unswerving friendship.
With your human resources and our support in pre-construction techniques, we can create a prospect we all desire.
Let's not do it your way or our way. Let's do it the best way.
Surrender to me for Louis. Collaboration wins.
Thank you.
Time's up. Oh, here come two students, Joe and Sylvia. Walking away from their school, they talked about the assignment given by Miss Lin.
Do you have any idea about the project?
What project?
The project of social study!
No, I haven't thought about it. Well, I think it is too hard for us since we never looked down on anybody. How do we know the feeling about discrimination?
But the due date is around the corner! We must hurry up and come up with a topic! Oh, the train's going to leave!
And here we are at the train station. I have no idea why they always sit on the floor like a bunch of aliens. It's so crowded. Why do they always gather here? The train station is a public area, and they can go somewhere else.
Maybe it's a bad place for them to get connection with friends, I guess.
Well, I got friends, but I'm not that annoying. Never mind, let's get on the train. As you can see, the seats are almost occupied. Oh, but except one.
Look, there's a seat.
What the earth are you doing?
What's wrong with you?
Are you okay? You can have a seat.
How awkward! A woman yelled at her seat. The girl took the seat, but no one is satisfied with this just because she's an alien worker, a forever outsider for us.
What do you want? What's your problem? I can't believe you just get me off the seat! It's so embarrassing!
Can't you see I'm trying to protect you?
Protect me from what?
Of course, the alien labor!
Are you kidding me? She's the only one who yells a seat! And you think she's a sort of creepy stranger? Hey, that's a stereotype!
Oh, I bet the girl didn't even realize that was a discrimination. I didn't realize it.
Well, maybe it's a time that you make some changes. Migrant workers deserve a chance to be treated equally and earn our respect.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry for that. So, what about our project? Do you have any idea?
Obviously, migrant workers might be a good choice since someone has just, you know, done some terrible things.
I didn't accept it. But how do we know more about them?
Actually, for the past 3 years, my grandfather has been taken care of by Leah. She comes from Indonesia.
Your ticket?
I can't! It's not easy for me to go back to Indonesia. I haven't come home for 6 years.
That must be very tough for you.
It's my decision and I need to get through all the obstacles.
That seems homesickness is not the only challenge that you need to face. It sounds like there's still tons of problems bothering you.
We are always considered to be breadwinners. However, seldom do you know how hard it would be to be torn apart from our families. And you have no idea how terrible they would be to be discriminated. You guys always keep a distance from us.
Leah, you have all my respect and I'm not going to let anyone hurt you.
Oh, Grandpa, that's so sweet.
You're the one who spent most of your life keeping my company.
Yeah, and you're the one who's always willing to share my feelings.
It never occurs to me, late alien, migrant workers suffer so much in our country.
Me too. Actually, I'm wondering, what can we do to help them?
What do you mean to help them?
To help them get rid of the discrimination.
Or maybe the first thing we can do is to make some changes. What do you think about inviting migrant workers to school?
You mean deliver a speech? Like, they can share their experience in Taiwan and we can communicate with them.
That's right. So people will know more about them and treat them better.
Time's up. Don't judge a book by its cover. We're all human beings and there's no difference between a Taiwanese and a foreigner. We have absolutely no right to do that. Why don't we embrace the differences?
And we will find that the people are